distinguished chief guest for the evening, Professor Srinivasan, Ms. Ratna Mukherjee, Ms. Anand Krishna, and Ms. Hassan of all of U.S. consulates, to whom this event has become possible, members of the guest audience, and delighted to see Dr. Srinivasan also as included in the audience. I have great pleasure in welcoming you all for this pleasant evening. And when I say welcoming you all, I'm also including all those out there who are connected to the web space, maybe watching this event live, being broadcast thanks to Asianet. The event being the presentation on a very contemporary topic, digital media marketing, by an eminent scholar in the field of journalism, Professor Srinivasan. Permit me to share with you a brief background to the kind of events that we organize through ASB. Consistent with ASB's vision of creating competent and caring management professionals with a passion to lead, we create opportunities for our students and other professionals to listen to and interact with leaders in various walks of life through this leadership lecture series and other similar events. Earlier speakers in this series include Dr. Ramadurai of TCS, Professor K.P. Kannan, and Professor Pulapare Balakrishnan of CDS, besides others. I'm sure we will organize more such lectures in the future too, given that we'll be able to host them in our own campus at Pallipuram. Incidentally, I invite you all to visit our campus too sometime. Though it is customary for the person doing the welcome to introduce the topic and the speaker, I have to resist my temptation to verbally blog, buzz and tweet now, right now, about the topic and the speaker, because my colleague, another Professor Srinivasan, Professor Rajiv Srinivasan, no relation, as Professor Rajiv Srinivasan could say, who is a lot more familiar with the speaker and the topic than I am, he will do the pleasant function of introducing the speaker and the topic. So I would conclude this very pleasant duty of mine of welcoming you all once again. Say thank you and invite Professor Rajiv to introduce the speaker on the topic. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Ramki. And once again, a welcome to all of you here, members of the audience, both from the U.S. Consulate and, of course, our guest, eminent guest, Professor Srinivasan. I'm going to take only about a minute because I know you're all eagerly awaiting his talk here. So I'm going to go through his resume that he gave me. He's Dean of Student Affairs and Digital Media Professor at the Columbia Journalism School, contributing editor of DNA Info, a hyperlocal Manhattan news site he helped launch in 2009. He's a technology expert and skeptic, which is an interesting dichotomy, isn't it? You know, how can you be a skeptic as well as an enthusiast? But he seems to manage that difficult task quite well. He's a commentator on tech and media issues. And in terms of honors, he's been recognized as one of Poynter's 35 most influential people in social media, one of Ad Age's 25 media people to follow on Twitter, one of the Society of Professional Journalists' top 25 journalists to follow on Twitter, and one of 22 professors named to the top 100 Twitterers in academia by onlineschools.org, and he's a judge for the Shorty Awards. He's also co-founder of the South Asian Journalists Association, and he has been, I think the SAJA as an organization has been active for about 10, 12 years, and they have instituted a series of online journalism awards, as well as SAJA awards, which are extremely well received, and they recognize the large number of South Asian media professionals who are doing a terrific job in the U.S. He also has been developing interesting courses. One of the courses that he did recently was on creating, distributing, and marketing digital content. So that relates very well to the topic at hand today. How can you use the burgeoning digital media, for example, Facebook, Twitter, and now the Google Plus entrant into the same speech state? It's an interesting area because in some ways it's also very, very fast moving. You may be familiar with the fact that the earliest social networks such as MySpace and others, Friendster, they've pretty much died, and Facebook is doing extremely well. So one of the questions I'd like to ask three is, Facebook is beginning to plateau a little bit in the U.S., at least in U.S. and North America. What does this mean for the future of Facebook? And perhaps what's most interesting to all of us is, what are the ways in which you can innovate and extract value from this ecosystem of digital media that's developing? And a couple of other topics that I wanted to ask Professor Srinivasan to talk about. One is, what he thinks about Google Plus. In fact, he has written an article for DNA Info about Google Plus, so I would request you to make some points about that. And finally, something that's extremely topical. Some of you may have read that tabloid called News of the World, which is owned by Rupert Murdoch, was closed yesterday. He closed it down because there was some kind of a hacking incident. And apparently the repercussions are quite dramatic. They say the British government may fall, or, I mean, I didn't quite understand it, so I'm going to ask Srinivasan to give us his opinion about that as well. He is here with his twins, Durga and Krishna. Is your wife here? No, she's not. Which is interesting. I wanted to ask him, his wife is a world-class rifle shooter, so he better be careful what he tells his wife, you know. You know, you have to tread carefully there. But with that, I think I will. I would like to request our chief guest to please take the podium. Thank you.
Thank you, everybody, for having me here, and especially to all of you for taking the time to spend the next hour or so as we discuss digital media. It's an honor to be back at Technopark. I have deep connections to Trivandrum, even though I live in the United States, and I travel. I grew up around the planet. I consider Trivandrum to be my hometown, my native place, and to see the kind of developments that have happened in Trivandrum is very heartening. And to visit at this particular time with all the news happening about Trivandrum in the temple, for example, has been just fascinating to see all of that. And I always tell people that the media scene in India is so different from what it is in the United States. Often when we are talking about the media scene in places like the U.S., you often feel that you're worried about the future of the media because of all the troubles that newspapers have been having. But it's when you come to a place like Trivandrum, you come to India, that you see how exciting the media market is and all the changes that are happening here. The number of newspapers, the number of television networks, it's just a great feeling for a professor of journalism to see all these changes and to see these, as I said, these sheer numbers and the level of excitement that there is in the media. What I'm going to be doing today is to talk about a couple of different things. I'll try to bring them all into some coherent thought, I hope, a set of thoughts. And Rajiv had asked also a range of interesting questions that could each be a half-hour conversation. But we'll give you plenty of opportunity to ask questions and to see if we can get to some of the things that are of deepest interest to you. I should also say that the Asian School of Business has a great slogan, because business is life. And that is something at the heart of what I talk about when I tell people, how do you figure out what kind of technology to embrace, because it's changing so fast.